Hello, hello, Spellbinders fans, and welcome back to our channel. My name is Yana Smakula. I am a creative designer here at Spellbinders, and today we have a special treat for you. A few card making ideas, all made using a typewriter die from our January card kit of the month. Over on our blog, if you are a follower, you might have noticed we have a new feature called Using Just Stamps and Dies. And these blog posts and the inspiration in them is there for you to help you create more with your Spellbinders kits. When you've used up all of the consumables from your card kits, you are still left with a stamp set and a die set that you can use for years to come. In this video, we wanted to share some inspiration using the typewriter die from our You're My Type card kit of the month. I've already started working on my first card. I die cut a typewriter out of black cardstock. You can choose to keep all of the negatives in, the little keys, the space bar, or you can punch them out and either layer different color cardstock underneath your typewriter or inlay the keys with other colors of cardstock. I'm going to cut out a similar shape using my scissors to mat under the typewriter. I decided I wanted to actually punch out all of the negative pieces, and so I grabbed my tool-in-one to help me do that. Fun tip for you, if you have our magnetic handy mat, you can flip it to the back, where there is a piercing side or a piercing mat, and use your tool-in-one on this side to make it easier to punch all of the negatives out. The mat is super soft, and the tool-in-one bristles easily poke through the die-cut openings to push the negatives out of your die-cuts and out of the way. And because the mat is magnetic, there's a magnetic strip embedded on one side of the mat at the very top, and will hold all of your dies in place when you flip it. Isn't that cool? I decided I wanted to foam mount my typewriter, so I pulled out black foam adhesive squares from my stash and added a few from the back of my die cut to foam mount this piece in place onto my gray matte piece. Looks much better this way, there's a little bit of dimension to the die cut. Next, in this die cut there is a little rectangle. This die will cut a piece of paper to insert into your typewriter to type a message. It is sized perfectly to fit inside the typewriter, no measuring or fussy cutting needed, and there's even a slit made in the typewriter die cut where this paper goes into. I'm going to stamp a simple sentiment on my paper using the stamps that are included in the January card kit. You can also purchase this stamp set separately as a part of our Card Club Kit Extras. The die, however, is not available separately and is only sold as a part of the January card kit of the month. I used my stamp platform and the Cave Black ink from Jane Davenport to stamp love, hugs, kisses, sentiment. All that's left to do now is to insert it into the typewriter. Super cute. For the card idea that I have in mind, I want to die cut a cute little border. For this, I pre-cut a piece of glitter paper, and I'm going to use one of the word dies from this set to die-cut a continuous XOXO. To help me align this die on the paper, I'm using a little trick with washi tape. The washi tape is actually going to be my guide and will help me align this die on the paper so that each cut is leveled with the previous one, just like so. You can also eyeball it, and I've tried it, but honestly, I find better, much better aligned results when I use the washi tape trick. The die cuts XOXO, and you have both the positive letters and the negatives. I'm only using the negatives to create my border, but I will also show you how you can use the excess to embellish your card, so do not toss these negatives, or rather positive die cuts, just yet. I trimmed my border to size and set it aside. Already dry embossed a panel for my card using the Love Stripe Embossing Folder from Fun Stamper Jury and white cardstock. I also cut another strip of pink cardstock to layer over the white one. I'm going to use double-sided tape and adhere the XOXO border onto the card about half an inch from the bottom edge. Trim the excess off using scissors and next layer the pink cardstock over it. I was planning to have just this pink panel at first, but later I added a panel of patterned paper over it to soften my card a bit. Now, that's where the positive die-cut letters come into play. I'm going to use the little X's and adhere these above the pink panel as little gold glitter cross stitch border. I think it looks really cute and it really dresses this card up. To save time, I'm only adding a few on each side and I'm skipping the section in the center where my typewriter is going to be. All that's left to do now is foam mount the typewriter in place and add a few gold glitter hearts. Our card is done. You can change up the sentiment and use it all year round, not just for the Valentine's Day. Moving on to card idea number two. Here, I've already created a delicate floral typewriter with the word love, die-cut in the piece of paper coming out from the typewriter. I used pattern paper to die-cut my typewriter from, and you can always, always use your pattern paper with your die-cuts. I know I have loads of pattern paper in my stash, and I'm so glad to try and deplete my stash at least a little bit with the help of dies. I also layered white glitter paper under the typewriter to have some sparkle on my card. For the background, I dry embossed a beautiful hearts background using the I Heart embossing folder, and my goal here is to simply foam mount the typewriter over my embossed background. I added a strip of gold glitter paper to coordinate with some of the leafy die cuts that I have embellishing my typewriter, and I adhere the embossed background onto an A2 white side folding card base. Just need to add my pink typewriter on top, and this card is done. Notice how I decorated the center of the typewriter with a little heart? That's where the make of the tool is usually mentioned, so I felt it was a good spot to add a little glitter heart to dress this card up. The little floral and leaves were also die-cut using the dies included with the typewriter. I cut them out of gold and white glitter paper, and finally I added a little mwah spelled out using some old alphabet stickers from my stash. Our second card is done. For my card idea number three, I decided to use little journaling cards that you would find in the 6x6 paper pads with the typewriter instead of the die-cut message. I did die-cut a rectangle using the die that's included with the typewriter, but I also added that little journaling card. For the background of this card, I dry embossed a piece of pattern paper using same I Heart embossing folder just to show you a different use. You don't always have to dry emboss white or colored cardstock. You can dry emboss patterned paper as well. I adhered my dry embossed panel onto an A2 white side folding card base. For my typewriter, like I mentioned, I used a journaling card in addition to that die-cut rectangle. I used foam adhesive to pop up the journaling card slightly, and next I added some more foam adhesive, but this time from the back of the typewriter, to secure some of the die-cut keys so that they do not fall out. I wanted to keep some inlaid in my typewriter and not punch all of them out this time. I remembered that I didn't add any backing to my typewriter. This time I decided to go with gold glitter paper, and once I had that in place, I foam mounted my typewriter onto the background. For this card, I placed the typewriter at the bottom of my panel and added several gold glitter die-cut leafy branches coming from the typewriter to the top of my card. I loosely adhered them in place, and that finished my card. Here's a close-up of this project. You can also catch more close-up photos and other inspiration on the Spellbinders blog. There's a link to the blog in the video description. I have one more card idea to share using the typewriter die from the January 2019 card kit of the month. For this card, I decided to do some background die cutting using the word dies in this kit. There are three dies that read XOXO, Love, and You Plus Me. They are all intended to go with the typewriter, to be die cut in that letter that fits inside the typewriter, but you can also use them on their own, like I did for a border on my first card, or like I'm doing here to die cut a background. At first, I wanted to die cut this in a card base so that one would be able to see through to the inside of the card. But later, I decided to change the card a little bit and use this as a background panel instead. I die cut the words three times each to fill up the entire height of the panel. I also layered a piece of light pink pattern paper under the die-cuts to have a little bit of pink show through the die-cut openings. For the typewriter, I used pattern paper and also added two journaling cards from the 6x6 paper pad from my stash. They're so cute and they went together perfectly with the typewriter. I actually cut up a bunch of pattern paper from my stash, cutting these typewriters out. I added a gold glitter die cut under the blue one to have a nice gold shadow peeking from behind it. I also trimmed my die cut to create a partial one as I wanted to have it positioned off to the side of the card. I foam mounted the typewriter in place. I added some beautiful florals and leaves, as well as the letter M in the center where the branding goes. And next, I adhered this panel onto an A2 white side folding card base. I had a blast making these cards with a typewriter die from the You're My Type January 2019 card kit from Spellbinders. This die is only available as a part of the kit, which is a membership subscription program. We have links to the club membership as well as to the Spellbinders blog listed below for more information and inspiration. I hope you'll give this idea a try. If you do, remember to share online and tag us on social media. We always love to see what you guys are making. On the screen, there is a link to a playlist with all of our club tutorials. Thanks for watching. Until next time.